In this video, we will take up the cytoskeletal structures. Now, when we use the word cytoskeleton, we are talking about cytoplasmic structures which are performing the skeletal job, that means providing shape, strength to the particular cell. And because they are present inside the cell, we are calling them cytoskeletal structures. And under the cytoskeletal structures, we would take two. One, microtubules. And the second are microfilaments. Let us first talk about the general structures, then we will take up the locations and the exact detail. Microtubules, these are hollow structures, that means they are pipe-like, whereas microfilaments are solid rod-like structures. So, when we see a pipe, there is a lumen inside, it has a wall and there is a space inside. That is how the microtubule structure is. And a solid rod-like structure, that is of microfilament. The second thing is, what exactly are they made up of? Microtubules are made up of tubulin proteins, whereas microfilaments are normally made up of actin protein and some amount of myosin Location, where exactly can we find these structures? Microtubules can be found in cilia, flagella, basal granules, spindle fibers, aster rays, and the exoneme of the sperm tail. And where do we find these microfilaments? Microfilaments are found, again, this is the location. These microfilaments are found in microvilli. These are the finger-like structures which are present in the cells to increase the area for absorption. These filaments are also found in cytoplasm, especially in the areas where pseudopodia are formed and in muscles. In muscles, both actin and myosin filaments are found. So this is just a comparative thing. Now let us talk about this microtubule in detail. It is a hollow pipe-like structure. So when we take a section, we see that it has a wall, and this wall is made up of 13 protofilaments. We have discussed this when we were talking about the structure of cilia, flagella, and even basal granules, and in case of centriole also. So here the wall has 13 protofilaments. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So this is how the wall is. Now let us take the diameter of this. The diameter of microtubules is 250 angstroms. But the space which is present inside, which we call the lumen, this is 150 angstroms. That means the thickness of the wall, this thickness of the wall is 50 angstroms here and 50 angstroms here. So there's a lumen. Now, how exactly are these structures made up of? Again, we have made this diagram earlier, but we'll quickly draw it. Suppose we are making this microtubule and this is the structure. Here, this microtubule is made up of tubulin protein. This tubulin protein is dimeric. Dimeric. That means there are two subunits. These subunits are called alpha and beta subunits. These alpha and beta subunits, they are spirally arranged to make the wall. Now let me make this. These are the tubulin subunits which we are drawing here. Let me make one more row and one more of, let us label this. The blue ones which we have drawn, say they are the alpha ones, and the red ones which we have drawn here, say this is the beta one. That means one alpha, one beta dimeric makes one tubulin structure. And now if we make a line out of it, say for example, this is one thread, and this thread is known as the protofilament. And from the top, we are going to see one structure here. So when we see this, this is actually made up of alpha and beta tubulin. This is going to be the other protofilament. This is going to be the third protofilament. And that is how there are 13 protofilaments which are there. And when we were talking about cilia flagella, we said that this microtubules, they also have subunits A, B, A, B, and C, which we call the doublets or the triplets. And A has 13, B has 10. Here we are talking about the main unit, which is made up of 13 protofilaments. So this structure, these are protofilaments. And this is the structure of the microtubule. These are the areas or parts where we can find them. We can add one more here, centriole. So they are the structures which are responsible for formation of cilia, flagella, centriole, basal granules, spindle fibers, etc. And all these structures, they have a distinct shape and they perform function. That means this structure is responsible for giving cilium or flagellum its shape, centriole its shape, basal granule also its shape and the strength. So this is why we are calling it as a cytoskeletal structure. Now coming to this microfilament part, microfilament, these are solid rod-like structures. So if we make this microfilament, it is solid. That means there are no spaces or lumens inside. And it is made up of a protein which is called actin. This actin is a fibrous protein. That means a thread-like thing. But this fibrous protein is made up of many globular proteins. That means this is a globular. Globular means the spherical ones. And these globular proteins join to form a fibrous protein. So this individual we call G-actin, and all of them together, they join to form a thread or a fiber-like structure, which is known as F-actin. G is for globular and F is for fibrous. So this is how the thread is formed, and it is solid, no lumen. Microvilli is one area where we would find these structures. So if we make a cell, and its free surface is going to have these finger-like structures which we call the microvilli. Now this finger-like structure has to stay in this particular manner, because if it again becomes flat, that structure would be lost. So to support these, there are these microfilaments which are in the form of supportive structures. Again, we said another area is cytoplasm or muscle. In cytoplasm, if a cell is producing this kind of a pseudopodium, say this is the extension, the pseudopodium, again, the cell would want that structure to remain in that extended form. So to support it, again, there has to be this kind of microfilamental support. But in the cytoplasm, whenever we make a cell, we make all other structures like nucleus and everything. And if you go back to those structures, you would find that we made some thread-like structures which are in the cytoplasm. These structures again give a framework to the cell. So they basically act as skeletal structures. So be it microtubule or microfilament, both are considered as cytoskeleton, and their main function is to provide strength and support to whichever part or the area where they are